Once again, we would like to formally welcome everyone here to a beautiful evening here at Steve Libro Field, the North Brunswick Township High School's home of the Raiders. On behalf of NBTHS, we would like to welcome the St. Joseph Falcons, their coaches, players, cheerleaders, and fans. Please know that there is no smoking anywhere on school grounds, and the school building is closed. Bathroom facilities are located on the scoreboard side of the home team stands, as well as next to the snack shack. And your refreshment needs can be met at the Joe Fritchie Raider Hut by the main entrance to the stadium. A reminder, there is no re-entry upon exiting the facility. Today's contest is being conducted according to the rules of the New Jersey State High School Athletic Association. These rules provide for fair competition among players. Spectators can help promote good sportsmanship by observing the rules of fair play. Any verbal, written, or physical conduct related to race, gender, ethnicity, disability, sexual orientation, or religion shall not be tolerated, could subject the violator to ejection, and may result in penalties being assessed against your team. Everyone is required to take personal responsibility for keeping this competition at a high level of good sportsmanship. We would like to remind everyone that these are high school students playing a game and are friendly rivals, not hostile opponents. We expect everyone to abide by the rules of good sportsmanship and to cheer for their team and not boo or disrespect their team, the other team, or the officials. The officials for today's event have been appointed by the BCC and the rules, as adopted by the NJSIAA, are different from those used in professional and college football. The scoreboard clock is the official time. The officials for tonight's game are Chris Simon, Dennis Horowzik, Michael Napolitano, Ralph Erica, Benancio Rivera, Victor Simon, James Muldowney, Anthony Muldowney, and Mike Marr. Before we begin all of our festivities, we would like to recognize all of the coaches here in North Brunswick Township for all of their dedication each and every day. We would like to thank Mr. Mike Sipot, head coach for the last 5 years, assistant coaches John Sipot, Nick Sipot, Pashawn Brown, Matt Mahalik, Paul Day, Raheem Byron, Dean Petrillo, Kevin Tott, Jake Rosenberg, Joe DePayne, Dan Gorzinski, and Kyle Harkins. And we also can't forget to thank our athletic trainer, Miss Mo, Jackie Morrison. For tonight's senior night, we want to take the time to acknowledge our seniors and their families. First, we want to extend our appreciation for all of the hard work and effort these student athletes put forth both in and out of the classroom. And of course, we thank the families for their support and contributions to our Raiders athletic program. To begin, we would like to recognize the senior athletes from the visiting St. Joseph Falcons. Thank you for being a part of today's contest. St. Joe's football seniors are number one, Christian Salino. Number three, Lucas Manello. Number four, Anthony Roige. Number seven, Alex Carinzi. Number nine, Prince Fontenay. Number 50, Kwame Herod. Number 60, Destin Kurzenberger. Number 53, Cameron Athol. Number 61, Evan Harris. And number 77, Xavier Day. Now, at this time, we would like to introduce our North Brunswick senior athletes. First, we will be starting with our football team managers. We would like to welcome Abigail Warren. She is being escorted by her father, Jack, and her sister, Charlie. She's been managing for 1 year and plans on attending a four-year university to hopefully pursue a career in physical therapy. Next, we would like to introduce manager Shannon Welsh. She has been managing the football team for the last 3 years. She's being escorted by her mom, Patty, her father, Bill, and her sisters, Erin and Kira. Shannon plans to attend Rutgers School of Engineering and major in Applied Sciences Engineering. Next, we would like to welcome Ms. Adrienne Solover, who has been a football team manager for the last 4 years. She's being escorted by her dad, Rick, her mom, Michelle, her brother, Andrew, and her cousin, Dan Gorzinski. Adrienne plans to attend the University of Delaware and major in psychology. Roll Blue Hens. Next, we would like to welcome the members of our seniors from the football team. First, we would like to welcome number 51, Denzel Bunzu. He's being escorted by his mom, Comfort, his father, Eric, his brother, Jason, and his sister, Chantel. Can't forget Joshua. He is an offensive lineman and the kicker here for the Raiders. He has been playing for the football team for the last 4 years. And he plans on playing college football and pursuing a career in business. Next, we would like to welcome number 26, Amir Buffalo. He is a linebacker here, and he is being escorted by his mother, Keisha, and his father, Brian. This is his first year playing football for North Brunswick. His future plans are that he plans to go to college and continue his education to become a mechanical engineer. Next, we would like to welcome number 55, Christian Dawson. He is an offensive tackle and linebacker who is being escorted by his mother, Velva, and his father, Michael. This is Christian's ninth year playing football. His future plans are that he wants to earn a degree in college and go into real estate, investing, and business ownership. Next, we would like to welcome number 7, Brandon Harrison. defensive end, and tight end. He's being escorted by his mother, Adrian Harrison, his aunt, and his cousins, Nate, Alicia, and Zaniah. This is his fourth year of playing high school football. His future plans are to play college football and study business. Next, we would like to welcome number 52, Muhammad Kamara. He is our nose guard and defensive tackle. This is his first year playing with North Brunswick. He's being escorted by his mom, Fanta, and his sisters, Zali and Mariana. Muhammad plans to attend a four-year college and major in computer science. Next, we would like to welcome number 5, Mary Macklin. He's being escorted by his mother, Tiffany. Amari is a linebacker here for the Raiders and has been playing for the last 4 years in North Brunswick. He plans to go to college for engineering. Next, we would like to welcome number 3, Ashwani Stewart, running back and linebacker for the Raiders. He's being escorted by his mother, Ronnie, his sister, Victoria, and his brothers, Gio and Jelani. This is Ashwani's first year playing with North Brunswick, and he plans to attend a fourth-year college. Next, we would like to welcome number 75, Hans Teada. Defensive and awesome offensive lineman. This is Hans' first year playing for the Raiders, and he's being escorted by his mom, Elizabeth, and his dad, Jesus. Hans plans to get into real estate after graduation. Next, we would like to welcome number 20, Bruce Wilker. He's a wide receiver and defensive back. This is Bruce's first year playing for the Raiders. He's being escorted by his mother, Kimberly, his sister, Brianna, his other sister, Erica, and his father, who is with him in spirit, but at work. In the future, Bruce plans to attend to college and hopefully get into the real estate business. Next, we would like to welcome one of our captains here for the Raiders, number 6, Jaden Myers. Jaden is a wide receiver and defensive back, who's being escorted by his mom, Laverne, his dad, Everton, and his sisters, Kelly and Shannon. Jaden has been playing for 11 years overall, and with the Raiders, he is currently number 2 all-time with receptions, number 5 all-team with receiving yards, and number 8 all-time with receptions. Jaden plans to attend a 4-year university and study business. And the last of our football players here on senior night is number 1, Captain Marquise Perry. Marquise is a wide receiver and safety, as well as our punter and returner. He's being escorted by his mother, Charisse, his father, Eddie, his sister, Aaliyah, and his brother, Michael. His brother, Deshaun, is the one who's been taking the team photos and videos. Marquise has been playing for 4 years for the Raiders and is currently number one all time with receptions. He is number two all time in receiving yards and number seven all time scorer here in North Brunswick Township. Marquise plans to attend a four-year college and continue to make his family proud in anything and everything he does in life. Let's give a huge round of applause for all our North Brunswick Township football seniors. Next, we would like to introduce our North Brunswick Township senior cheerleaders. First, we have Christina Kofer, who's being escorted by her mom, Crystal, her dad, Ernest, as well as Cedric and her grandma, Shirley. Christina is one of the senior captains and has been on the varsity team for 3 years. In the future, she plans to attend a four-year university and major in nursing. Next, we would like to welcome Sierra Dorch, who's being escorted by her mom, Yolanda, her father, Curtis, and her sisters, Paima, Sade, and Chantel. Sierra is one of the senior captains and has been part of the varsity team for 3 years. In the future, she plans to go to college to major in law and become a successful lawyer or prosecutor. Next, we would like to welcome Tania Edwards, who's being escorted by her mom, Kristen, her dad, Tremaine, her grandmother, Karen, and her grandfather, Raymond. Tania has been part of the varsity team for 1 year. In the future, she plans to go to college and major in either business or fashion merchandise and pursue her career in those fields. Next, we would like to welcome Gabriella Gaskell. She's being escorted by her mom, Michelle, her dad, Michael, and her sister, Danielle. Gabriella has been part of the varsity team for 2 years. In the future, she plans to attend and graduate from an out-of-state university. Next, we would like to welcome Christina Goy, who's being escorted by her mom, Joanne, and her sister, Jenna. Christina's been part of the varsity team for 3 years. In the future, she plans on going to nursing school and wants to travel. Next, we would like to welcome Sophia Haluska, who's being escorted by her mom, Noelle, her dad, Michael, and her brother, Michael. Sophia has been a member of the varsity team for 2 years. In the future, she plans to continue her career in college, graduate with a bachelor's degree in biological sciences, and attend medical school and become an OBGYN. Next, we would like to welcome Jada Manaya, who's being escorted by her mom, Irma, her father, Cesar, and her sister, Jasleen. Jada has been a member of the varsity team for 3 years. In the future, she plans to go to college and become a veterinarian. Next, we would like to welcome Karina Patel, who's being escorted by her mom, Tara, and her sister, Maya. Karina has been a member of the varsity team for 1 year. In the future, she plans to attend a four-year university Measuring in Psychology. Next, we would like to welcome Samantha Rossman, who's being escorted by her mom and dad, Melissa and Mark, her grandma, Carol, her grandpa, Howard, and her brother, Alex. Samantha is one of the senior captains and has been part of the cheerleading program for 3 years. In the future, she plans to go to college and work. Next, we would like to welcome our captain, Emma Rudolph, who's being escorted by her mom, Mary Beth, dad, Dave, and brother, Andrew. Emma is the fourth of our senior captains and has been part of the cheerleading program for 3 years. In the future, she plans to go to college and work as an arts and entertainment manager. Lastly, we would like to welcome Rosemary Veris, escorted by her mom, Ramona, her dad, Roberto, her sister, Vislady, and her brother, Justin. Rosemary has been a main member of the varsity cheer team for 3 years. And in the future, she plans to attend a four-year college and become a neonatal nurse. Let's give one nice round of applause for all of our Raiders cheerleaders here on Senior Night. To welcome the members of our NBTHS Raider Marching Band. The first of our seniors is Miss Mia Kelly, who's being escorted by her mother, Trini, her father, Andrew, and her brother, Carson. Mia has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. She is a member of the flute piccolo section, the leader of that section, as well as one of our drum majors. Mia plans to major in biomedical engineering or exercise science at a four-year university and then get her doctorate in physical therapy. Next, we would like to welcome Natalie Tom, who's being escorted by her father, Gene Tom, and her mother, Linda Yen. Natalie has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. She is a member of the pit percussion section, as well as a drum captain. Natalie plans to attend a four-year university and then law school. Next, we would like to welcome Gori Banganwar, who's been escorted by her mother, Aditi. She has been in the marching band for 4 years. Gori is a member of the color guard section and a color guard captain. Gori plans to major in biomedical engineering and hopes to work in a research lab after she graduates college. Next, we would like to welcome Arko Hassan, who's being escorted by his father, Mahmoud Hassan. Arko has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. He is a section leader in the trumpet and mellophone section, as well as a field major. In the future, Arko plans to study computer science and recording technology. Next, we would like to welcome Om Jariwala, who's being escorted by her father, Deepak, and her mother, Bina. She has been a member of the cheerleading squad for 5 years. Ohm is a member of the drum line and a drum captain. In the future, Ohm plans to study finance at Rutgers. Next, we would like to welcome Dhruv Shah. Dhruv is being escorted by his father, Kaushal, his mother, Chaitali, and his brother, Arav. Dhruv has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. He is also a member of the pit percussion section and drum captain. Dhruv plans to attend college, pursuing a degree in economics, and then hopes to start a career in politics in Washington, D.C. Next, we would like to welcome Natalie Lukonen. Natalie is being escorted by her mother, Victoria, and her father, Vasily. Natalie has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. She is a section leader in the trumpet section, as well as a field major. Natalie plans to go to college for psychology and continuing music through other clubs and activities. Next, we would like to welcome Ashna Sinha. Ashna is being escorted by the mother, Sonali Sinha, father, Vivek Sinha, and her brother, Anish Sinha. Ashna has been a member of the marching band for 1 year. Ashna is a member of the Color Guard and plans to pursue her secondary education. Next, we would like to welcome Emma Farrell, who's being escorted by her mother, Jennifer, father, Chris, and sister, Lindsay. Emma has been a member of the marching band for 4 years in the clarinet section. Emma plans to go to college and major in nursing with hopes of pursuing a career as a neonatal nurse practitioner. Next, we would like to welcome Mayrin Hernandez, who's being escorted by her friends, Julie and Liam. Mayrin has been a member for the marching band for 1 year and is a member of the pit percussion section. Mayrin plans to go into pediatric nursing. Next, we would like to welcome Javier Shimon, who's being escorted by their sibling, Osvaldo. Javier has been a member of the marching band for 1 year in the trumpet section. Javier plans to go to Middlesex County College and to have a nice start in college. Next, we would like to welcome Anthony Zoltan Russo. Anthony's being escorted by his mother, Susanna Russo, uncle Anthony Russo, and his friend, Nicholas Farron. Anthony has been a member of the marching band for 5 years in the alto saxophone section. He is also the leader of that section and a field major. Anthony plans to go to college for the arts and writing and spend time with his girlfriend. Next, we would like to welcome Vabav Garg, who's being escorted by the mother, Rashmi Garg, father, Vijay, and brother, Parth. Vabav has been a member of the marching band for 4 years in the clarinet section. Vabav plans to go to college to study computer engineering. Next, we would like to welcome Karan Chowdhury. Karan's being escorted by the father, Sachin, and mother, Shilpa G. Karan has been a member of the marching band for 4 years in the pit percussion section. Karan plans to go to college and study mechanical engineering. Next, we would like to welcome Maryam Farouk, who's being escorted by her father, Reza Farouk, and her mother, Naheed Faha. Maryam has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. Maryam is a color guard captain in the color guard section. Maryam plans to study biology in college and later get her MD to become a pediatrician. Next, we would like to welcome Lucas Ciernos, who's being escorted by his father, Joe, and his mother, Lema. Lucas has been a member of the marching band for 4 years and is part of the mellophone section. Lucas plans to go to college and study computer science. Next, we would like to welcome Christian Williams. Christian's being escorted by the mother, Denise Williams, father, Lamont Williams, and the cousin, Kiara Clements. Christian has been a member of the marching band for 4 years in the low brass section. Christian plans to go to college for zoology and art. Next, we would like to welcome Mr. Xavier Moore. Xavier is being escorted by his mother, Mrs. Karen Moore, his father, Mr. Thomas Moore, and his sister, Chara Moore. Xavier has been a member of the marching band for 5 years. Xavier is a member of the low brass section, as well as a section leader and one of our drum majors. Xavier's future plans are to go to college to learn about music education or anything music related. Lastly, we would like to welcome Amelvin Mina. Amelvin's being escorted by his mother, Maritza Gomez, father, Kelvin Mina, and cousin, Christian Gomez. Amelvin has been a member of the marching band for 4 years. Amelvin is also a section leader and plays tenor saxophone. Amelvin plans to attend Rutgers for mechanical engineering and music performance. We would like everyone to give a big round of applause for our North Brunswick High School marching band, as well as all of our seniors here on senior night at Steve Libro Field. Thank you. We now ask that everyone rise, remove your head coverings, and face the flag for the singing of the national anthem. Tonight's anthem will be performed by members of the NBTHS Honors Choir and Vocal Techniques Ensemble under the direction of Ms. Moreno. As with all the seniors here at Senior Night, we would like to recognize five seniors that are performing. First, we have Margaret Schmidt, soprano. Ariana Hodge, soprano. Emily Camlett, alto. Amani Somachi, alto. And Javian Rojas, bass. As we get ready for our coin toss here at Stephen Monroe Field, don't forget to stop by the Joint Refrigerator Hut for any of your food and beverage needs. If you would like to listen to the broadcast of tonight's game, check out the King James Radio Network. Corbin has been covering North Brunswick football here for over 10 years. That's at jamesisking.com. For the coin toss is number 9, Willie Wilson. Number 1, Marquise Perry. Number 6, Jaden Myers. And number 10, Frankie Garbalino. To the coin toss, St. Joseph Falcons will receive. about to kick for the Raiders is number 51, Denzel Mosu. Back to receivers, number 26. Isaiah Barnes. It'll be a first and 10 for the Falcons from their own 23-yard line. St. Joe's from the 29-yard line, on 34-yard line. St. Joe's at the 39-yard line as we are at the 10:45 to go in the first quarter. St. Joe's inside North Brunswick territory at the 26-yard line. Christian Salino hands off to number 26, Jeremy DeCaro, runs into a flock of Raiders, and is stopped for no gain. It'll be a second and 10 for St. Joseph with 8:30 to go in the first quarter. Number 1, Christian Salino passes to the inside, number 10, it'll be a third down and 10 for St. Joseph with an 8:05 to go in the third quarter. St. Joe's. So that will back them up a full attack. And then we'll kick. It'll be a 4th-and-29 for St. Joe's as they prepare a kick from the 34-yard line. First and 10 for the Raiders from their own 40-yard line with 7:37 to go in the first quarter. Now's a great time to run over to the Joe Fritchie Raider Hut for any of your food and beverage needs. And don't forget to look for members of the Touchdown Club that are selling 50-50 tickets for tonight's raffle. Tickets to be drawn at halftime.
Thank you.
Warriors offense stays on the field to attempt the two-point conversion by Frank Romano's pass falls incomplete. Intended for number six, Jaden Cross. Touchdown Club sponsors this year. And that'll make the score North Brunswick 6 and St. Joseph 0 with 6:52 to go in the first quarter. On tag up for the Raiders is number 51, Denza Bonzo. To number 16, Dustin Hertzenberger, runs into a pack of Raiders and gains 2 yards. It'll be a second and 13 for St. Joseph's from the 37-yard line. St. Joseph's. Looks like it stopped for a short game, but they keep breaking tackles and moving the pile, and he has enough for a Falcons first down. First down, St. Joseph's inside Raider territory at the 49. Handoff goes to number 16, Destin Hertzenberger. He gains 4 on the play, but not before he stopped by number 79, Arnold Samuels. It'll be a 2nd and 7 for St. Joseph with under 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Thank you. To the left-hand side, looking for number one, Marquise Perry, but intercepted. Interception was made by number five, JoJo Hunter. That'll give Sanchez the ball back. At the own 20-yard line on the touchback. First and 10 for the Falcons with 3:15 to go in the first quarter.
Here!
As we get ready for the second quarter here at Steve Lebo Field, we want to tell you to don't forget to see the touchdown club for any of your 50-50 tickets. While you're out walking around, don't forget to see the Joe Fritchie Raider hat for any of your refreshment needs. It'll be a first and goal for the Falcons from the 9-yard line. Number one, Chris Cicino rolls out to the left-hand side looking for someone open. Finally finds number 26, Jeremy DeCaro. In on the tackle were number 7, Brandon Harrison, and number 24, Tamir Jenkins. first to four from the five. On for the extra point was number 66, Daniel Cortez, and it is up and through. That'll make the score St. Joe 7 and our Lord Brunswick Raiders 6 with 10:59 to go in the first half. On to kick off for St. Joe's is number 66. Kicks received by number 2, Zamir Dahoud. Short return on the play, and he will be tackled at the North Brunswick 15-yard line. There will be a first down Raiders with 10:48 to go in the second quarter. Direct snap to number 1, Marquise Perry.
Yeah, John, remind him to tuck that ball away.
It'll be a gain of 6 on the play. That'll give the Raiders a second down and 4 from their 21-yard line. Number 10, Frank Garbolino, hands off to number 3, Ashwani Stewart. Looking for room up the middle. And he has stopped a yard short of a first down. It'll be a 3rd and 1 for North Brunswick from their own 24-yard line, as we have 9:40 to go in the first half. Before the snap is made, flag on the play, and that is a false start against North Brunswick. That'll back the Raiders up 5 and give them a 3rd down and 6. Thank you. Number 10, Frank Avellino, sprints out to the left-hand side, looking for number 3, Shaquille Stewart, but the pass falls incomplete. It'll be a 4th down and 6 for North Brunswick, deep in their own territory, at the 19-yard line. Punt from number 1, Marquise Perry, is recovered by number 26, Destin Hertzenberger. First down. Number 1, Christian Cimino, looking to the right-hand side, hits number 4, Anthony Roget, and he is enough for a St. Joe's first down. First to 10 for the Falcons at the North Brunswick 32-yard line. Whistle before the snap will be a timeout by St. Joe's. That'll be their first charge timeout of the first half. With 6:24 to go in the second quarter. As always, we want to thank everyone coming out tonight. We want to thank everyone that makes tonight possible. We want to give a thank you to our acting superintendent, Ms. Janet Soroka. Our principal here at North Brunswick Township High School, Mr. Michael Miller, and our athletic director, Mr. Sean Murray. St. Joe's at the North Brunswick 19-yard line. Number one, Christian Salino, hands off to number 16, Destin Gertzenberger. 5 yard gain on the play. First in on the tackle was number 8, Jared Tynes. Number 1, Christian Salino back to pass. Pass ball is incomplete. Intended for number 4, Anthony Rojan. It'll be a 4th down and 5.
Block right. Go get it.
For the St. Joe's Falcons. From the Raider 14-yard line. On to attempt the field goal for the Falcons is number 66, Daniel Cordes. Cordes's kick is up and through.
Hey, did we get a piece on that?
30-yard field goal for number 66, Daniel Cordes, will make the score here. St. Joe's 10. And North Brunswick 6, with 4:31 to go in the first half. As we approach halftime, I want to remind everyone to stop and get your 50-50 tickets from the Touchdown Club. Winning ticket will be drawn at halftime. We also want to give a big shout out for our North Brunswick cheerleading squad, our North Brunswick marching band. On to kick for St. Joe's is number 66, Daniel Cordes. Back deep to receive is number 6, Jada Myers. And that kick will roll into the end zone and be a touchback. Thank you. It'll be a first down for the Raiders from their own 20-yard line with 4:30 to go in the first half. There's a flag at the end of the play, and that will be against the Raiders. And that'll back them up 10 yards. It'll be a first and 10 North Brunswick from the run 10-yard line. Handoff goes to number one, Marquise Perry on the jet sweep. Finds room to the left-hand side and has a nice gain of 8 on the play. It'll be a second and 2 for the Raiders as we tick within 4:05 to go in the first half. St. Joe's 46.
This one out.
First and 10 for the Raiders with 3:49 to go in the first half. Number 10, Frankie Vimbolino, hands off to number 3, Ashwani Stewart. Fighting for yardage on the right-hand side and gains a little bit more than a yard. It'll be a 2nd and 9 for North Brunswick from the 13-yard line of St. Joe's. Denzel Bonzu. 13-yard touchdown run was built by Luder Steele.
Hey, Poo.
Who continues to sponsor a touchdown club each year here at Steve Levo Field. If you want to support the touchdown club, don't forget to purchase those last minute 50-50 tickets before the time. Samir DeWood. It'll be a first and 10 for the Falcons. But we're all 32 yard line as we have less than 2 minutes to play for the first half. To attempt the extra point for North Brunswick is number 51, Denzel Bonser. Support the touchdown club as well. Get those last minute 50-50 tickets. With 1:31 to go in the first half, the score is the North Brunswick Raiders 20 and the St. Joe's Falcons 10. Thank you. The split kick from number 51, Denzel Batsu, will roll its way all the way down and into the end zone for a touchdown.
Good job, Denzel. That was perfect.
It'll be a first and 10 for St. Joe's from their own 20-yard line. 1:27 to go in the second quarter. With 1:21 to go in the first half. At the end of the play, that whistle was the second charge timeout for the St. Joe's Falcons, with 1:12 to go in the first half. As we get ready for our halftime festivities, don't forget to stop by the Joe Fitcher Raider Hut for any of your food and beverage needs. Don't forget to be courteous and discard your trash in the proper waste receptacles. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, back to pass. Chased out of the pocket, and the ball falls incomplete out of bounds. Second and 10 for the Raiders with 55 seconds to go in the first half. Thank you. Number 10, Frankie Barbarina, fires across the one, middle. Complete to number one, Marquise Perry, for a gain of six on the play. It'll be a third down and four for the Raiders as they take their first charge timeout. For the first half, with 48 seconds to go. That'll be the Raiders' second charge timeout of the first half. That flag is holding against the Raiders. And it'll back them up 10. It'll be a third down and 17 for the Raiders, all the way back at the St. Joe's 45-yard line, with 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Too high. I think we can take a shot down here, maybe.
Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, back to pass. Garbellino's pass is intercepted by number 16, Destin Kritzenberger. That turnover will give the Falcons a first and 10 deep in their own territory at their 23-yard line with 30 seconds to go in the half.
If Zamir drops out, he's wide open. Corners fail, but
number one, Christian Cerullo, back in the pass, chased out of the pocket, and eventually dragged down from behind by number 13, Emmanuel Gray. That's not before he's able to gain 8 yards on the play and give them a second and two. However, as the clock ticks down, that whistle will mean that it is halftime here at Steve Lebro Field. End of the first half, it's the North Brunswick Raiders 20 and the St. Joseph Falcons 10. As we get ready for our halftime festivities here at Steve Lebro Field, we would first like to introduce our 2021 Raiders cheerleading squad. Our our seniors are captains Christina Kofer, Sierra Deutsch, Samantha Rossman, and Emma Rudolph. Our other seniors are Tania Edwards, Gabriella Gaskell, Christina Goy, Sophia Haluska, Jada Manaya, Karina Patel, and Rosemary Barris. Our juniors are Ariana Alvarado Velasco, Madeline Colon, Chantel Dorch, Amira Fitzpatrick, Lamaya Jenkins, Sky Mater, Nikki Newman, Jaden Oglesby, Brianna Vansluten, and Sydney Ward. And our sophomores are Ayana Fisher and Jada Soda. The team is coached by Mrs. Doyle and Mrs. Wright. Take it away, ladies. Let's give a huge round of applause for our North Brunswick cheerleading squad. Now we would like to welcome our North Brunswick Township High School Rear Marching Band. They will be performing their 2021 show, Get the Laugh. Our band director is Miss Danielle Ludeman. Our assistant directors are Jeffrey Smith and Stephen Comer. And the supervisor of music here at North Brunswick Township is Mr. Jamie Egan. The percussion director is Paul Bongiovi. Instructor is Mrs. Danielle Tamarana. Our marching techs are Rachel Clark, Isaiah C. Mason, Chris English. Drill design is by Chris Burbank. Our drum majors this year are seniors Xavier Warren and Mia Kelly. Our color guard captains are Rory Banganwell, Celeste McKenzie, and Miriam Farouk. Our percussion captains are Om Jarawala, Aruvi Vakalagada, Natalie Tom, and Drew Shah. Is the band ready? marching band. Excellent job tonight, everyone. As we get ready to conclude our festivities here at halftime, we would like to announce our winning 50-50 ticket from the Touchdown Club. The winner tonight will get $145. Tonight we have a white ticket. Ticket number 134264. Once again, that's a white ticket. 134264.
Thank you.
We want to welcome everyone back after halftime for the second half of football tonight here at Steve Lebo Field. On to kick for St. Joe's is number 66, Daniel Cortez. Back deep to receive for the Raiders is number 6, Jaden Meyer. Kicks received by number 6, Jaden Myers at the 2. Brings it out to the Raiders' 24-yard line. First down, North Brunswick. Number 10, Frankie Barbolino, hands off to number 3, Ishwani Stewart. charges forward and has a nice gain of 9 on the play. It'll be a 2nd and 1 for the Raiders. But we're on 33-yard line. Number 10, Frankie Garbarino, hands off to number 1, Marquise Perry, finds a hole up the middle, and he has enough for a Raiders first down. First and 10, North Brunswick, 3-1. Frankie Garbellino hands off to number 3, Ashwani Stewart. Looking for room on the left-hand side, and he gains a yard. It'll be a 2nd down and 9 from the 40-yard line. Number 10, Frankie Garbarino, sprinting out to the right side, looking for somebody open, and he's tripped up and brought down by number 9, Dan Masseria. Loss of 2 on the play will give the Raiders a 3rd down and 11 from their 38-yard line, with under 9:45 to go in the 3rd quarter. Number 10, Frankie Garbarino, and rolls out left and hits number 6, Jaden Myers, for another Raiders first down. 14-yard completion on the play will get North Brunswick a first down inside San Jose territory at the 48-yard line. Number 10, Frankie Garbarino takes the handoff, shovel pass to number 6, Jaden Myers, who finds room up the middle, and has another Raiders first down. First down, North Brunswick, inside the 35-yard line. Frankie Garbarino hands off to number 1, Marquise Perry. Loses a yard on the play. It'll be a 2nd and 11 for North Brunswick from the St. Joe's 35-yard line. Number 10, Frankie Garbarino, heads up to number 3, Ashwani Stewart, on the right hand side, makes a nice little move, has enough for a Raiders first down. First down, North Brunswick, deep in St. Joe's territory at the 11-yard line. Thank you. On to attempt the exploit is number 51, Denzel Bunsell. Flag on the play is encroachment against the defense. That'll move the Raiders' try up to the 2. And the offense will come back on the field. Sponsors this year, as that run has made the score of Northwestern Raiders 28 and the St. Joseph Falcons 10. On to kick for the Raiders is number 51, Denzel Bunsell. Back to receive is number 26, Jeremy DeCaro, and number 15, Quality Hill. Number 1, Christian Salino, hits number 10, Christian Maglicano in the flat. He has enough for a Falcons first down. Eventually brought down by number 24, Tamir Jenkins. It will be a first attempt for St. Joe's from their own 38-yard line, as we have less than 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Christian number 16, Destin Pritzenberger, dragged down at the line of scrimmage by number 5, Amari Macklin. No gain on the play, will be a 2nd and 10 for St. Joe's. That flag will be holding in St. Joe's. That'll back him all the way up to their 23-yard line. It'll be a 2nd down and 25 for St. Joe's with 4:30 to go in the third quarter. Handoff goes to number 16, Destin Kurtzenberger. Brought down by the duo of number 5, Amari Macklin, and number 24, Tamir Jenkins. 6-yard gain on the play will give the Falcons a 3rd and 19 from their own 26-yard line. Loss of 4 on the play will give the Raiders a 2nd down and 14 from their 24-yard line.
Got him.
Number 10, Frankie Garbolino hits number 3, Ashwani Stewart on the screen. However, there is a flag on the play. That flag on the play is in the vicinity of holding. And we'll back the Raiders up all the way to their own 14-yard line as they replay second down. Number 10, Frankie Garbolino hands off to number 1, Marquise Perry, looking for room around the right-hand side, and he's able to gain about 5 yards on the play. It'll be a third down and 17 for North Brunswick, with 1:10 to go in the third quarter.
You want Amari out and Jack in?
Frankie Garbolino back to pass, chased out of the pocket. The pass falls incomplete, but there's another hold on the play. The holding call will be denied, and the Raiders are on to punt.
Cover, Willie! Willie, go!
Marquise Perry's punt is received by number 26, Jeremy DeCaro. In on the tackle is number 55, Christian Dawson. First and 10 for the Falcons from the Raiders' 41-yard line. As we have 26 to go in the third quarter. With 17 seconds to go in the third quarter. Number 1, Christian Cimino hands off to number 16. Destin Kurtzenberger. Brought down by a Syndicate of Raiders. And with that whistle, that's the end of the third quarter here at Steve Liebro Field, with our Raiders leading St. Joe's 28-10. Zamir DeWitt. It'll be a 2nd and 10 for the Raiders from the 43-yard line. Stewart slashing his way through the left-hand side, and he's near the first down marker. It'll be a 3rd down and 1 for the Raiders inside St. Joe's territory at the 48-yard line. St. Joe's. Come on, first and 10 for the Falcons at the North Brunswick 42-yard line with 9:54 to go in the fourth quarter. Number one, Christian Salino fires to the left-hand side and completes. And number five, JoJo Huntley. That's enough for a first down, St. Joe's. In on the tackle were number one, Marquise Perry, and number 12, Jacko Molina. First and 10, Falcons inside the Raiders 40 at the 39-yard line as we approach 8 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Salino looking for number five, JoJo Huntley, and the pass is complete. Looks like number five is a little beaten up on the play. That'll be a first and goal for the Falcons inside the Raiders' 10-yard line at the 7. That was whistle will be a timeout taken by the Raiders. It will be North Baltimore's first timeout of the second half. As we come out of the timeout, it'll be a first and goal for St. Joe's from the North Brunswick 7-yard line. Number one, Christian Salino, hands off to number 26, Jeremy DeCaro. Finds room, and he is in for the Falcons' touchdown. The St. Joe's offense will stay on the field and go for the two-point conversion. Chris Salino passes to the right-hand side and complete to number four, Anthony Roget. That'll bring the St. Joe's Falcons within 10. As the Raiders lead here, 28-18, with just under 7 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. As we get ready for the kickoff here in the fourth quarter, we want to thank everyone who helped to make tonight possible, specifically our facilities crew, Dave, Danny, and George, as well as our athletic trainer, Miss Muller, site supervisor, Miss Sadowski. St. Joe's kicks it deep, and it'll roll into the end zone for a touchback. It'll be a first and 10 for the Raiders from their own 20-yard line, with 6:56 to go in the fourth quarter. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hands off to number 1, Marquise Perry. Gains a yard up the middle before he's stopped. It'll be a 2nd and 9 for North Brunswick. With 6:30 to go in the fourth quarter. Thank you. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hands off to number 3, Ishwani Stewart. Moves the pile forward and gains 4 in the play. It'll be a 3rd down and 5 for the Raiders as we have 5:45 to go in the 4th quarter. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, finds number 6, Jaden Myers, and he is enough for a Raiders first down. First down, North Brunswick at the 31-yard line. This is Michelle Downs. That flag is encroachment against the defense. And that'll give the Raiders a 1st down and 5. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hits number 3, Ishwani Stewart on the swing pass. He is close to a Raiders first down. And that's enough yards for a Raiders first down. First down, North Brunswick, as the clock ticks within 4:50 to go in the 4th quarter. Garbellino hands off to number 3, Ishwani Stewart, fighting for yardage, and he gains 3 on the play. It'll be a 2nd down and 7 for the Raiders as we approach 4 minutes to go in the 4th quarter. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hands it off to number 8, Jared Tynes, finds some room, cuts it back inside, and he's enough for a Raiders first down. First down, North Brunswick, inside St. Joe's territory at the 45-yard line as the clock runs and we approach 3 minutes to go in the game. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino picks the handoff, shovel pass to number 6, Jaden Myers, got enough room on the left-hand side, and he is enough for Raiders' first down. Jaden Meyer slides down to keep the clock running at the 32-yard line as we approach 2 minutes to go in the game. That whistle will be Sancho's first charge timeout of the fourth quarter. As the clock winds down, we want to thank everyone who made it here tonight on senior night. We want to thank our marching band as well as our cheerleading squad. And ask that you please be kind and make sure all of your garbage goes in the proper waste receptacles. As we come out of the timeout, it's first down North Brunswick with 1:58 to go in regulation. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hands off to number 3, Ashwani Stewart. Finds room around the left-hand side and gains 6 of the play. It'll be a second down and 4 for the Raiders as we approach 1:30 to go in regulation. Number 10, Frankie Garbellino, hands off to number 5, Amari Macklin. However, he's met and dropped in the backfield for a loss of 4. It'll be a third down and 8 for the Raiders from the St. Joseph's 30-yard line as we have 40 seconds to go in the game. That whistle will be the Raiders' second charge timeout of the second half with 18 seconds to go. Snaps taken by number 1, Marquise Perry, and he went down the ball. As the clock winds down, now we'll end our game here at Steeler Field with our North Brunswick Raiders 28 and the St. Joseph Falcons 18. We'll be right back.
Yeah.